So here's the before with all the background noise. And here's the after. Silence is golden. What's up everybody, it's Shaq Ultra, and today I'm gonna show you how to remove that annoying background hiss. I already made a video like this before, but this one is gonna be updated. First thing you wanna do is go to Google and search FL Studio account signup. Once you're there, you wanna click sign up, image line, search FL Studio. It'll bring you to this page. So go ahead and fill it out with all your information. After you're done entering your information, make sure to click I am not a robot, and then click create an account. After you've created your account, it says you still need to verify your email address. You actually have to do this. So I'm gonna go to my temp email and boom, I have the email from ImageLine right here. So I'm gonna click on that and then click on this first link. And that link should verify you and boom, email verified successfully. After that, you wanna go back to Google and you wanna search mini host modular. We're gonna be using a plugin within that program, but we need this first. And that's why we need the FL Studio account. Click on that first link and it should bring you to this page. Click get the beta here and log in to your account or create one to get access. And since you're already logged in, they're just gonna ask you for a form username, submit. And once you're in, it'll say get Windows installer here. This zip is the one you wanna download. So you wanna click download. And then you see I have a whole bunch of them already downloaded up here because I was testing this out before. You wanna go to your Explorer, go to your downloads folder, and then you're gonna have one that looks like this. It's gonna look like a zip folder. And you wanna click extract all and just click extract. And for me, it's gonna say replace because I already have one in there. And then you're going to see one file like this. So after that, you wanna right click this file, click properties, and this location, you want to copy it. Then you wanna click start and type in CMD and you'll get command prompt. Right click it and run it as administrator. Then this thing that you copied right here, the properties for that mini host install, you want to right click into this window to paste it. And then you want to put slash the name of this thing. You want to copy it, the name of the program. And then you want to put .exe and then press enter. After that, it'll start unpacking it. The reason I'm doing it this way is because there was an issue before when I tried to just double click it and run it. So this is the way around that. So you just keep clicking next. And then it'll install. And you can close out of the command prompt and this other page and this and your Explorer. Click start, find the 64-bit version of the mini host modular. Click that and make sure it's allowed access and then click OK. So now that's set up, you need to go to Google and search Reaper plugins. Rhea plugs Reaper will come up and you need to download the 64-bit version right here. Keep it and then open the file and run it and install it. And then after it says completed right here, you can click close. Then you want to go back into your mini host modular. You want to go to file, then preferences, change your audio device type to ASIO, change your device to Voicemeeter insert virtual ASIO. Click that. Then you want to go to your plugins and you want to go to browse, go to your local disk C program files, VST plugins, and Rhea plugs. And then you want to just click on that folder, click OK, and then click scan and verify. And then it will add all of these plugins. And once all these plugins are added, you see the Rhea first standalone. That's the one we're going to need. So now I want to show you the before and after you edit your mic settings. So here's the before with all the background noise. And here's the after. So you want to make sure your mini host is open, of course. Click OK. Right click, add plugin, reefer standalone. Then you want to drag your audio in to your audio in and your audio out to your audio out. Then in this mode section, you want to click the drop down box and click subtract. Once you do, on the right side, a box will pop up. You're going to click that box and be as quiet as you can for 10 seconds while you let the standalone get the noise floor of your room. Then you want to unclick it. Once you unclick it, you want to go back into Voicemeeter, click menu. Be aware of this restart audio engine because we're going to need it in a minute. But you're going to go down to system settings slash options. And then this box right here, in one left and in one right, you want to click both of those and then click restart audio engine, the one I just showed you a second ago. Also, quick tip. You can save your configuration for the reefer standalone by going to File, Save Graph As, and you can save it to where you want on your computer. Your recording environment can change all the time, so just every once in a while, automatically build your noise profile so this red line is actually over the ambient noise in your room. Another thing I like to do is turn this audio ability gate up to 2, but that might be different for you. But it keeps out some more unwanted noise.